Guys, the time has come for the pre-pour check, and we're gonna be checking everything after all is marked now, all is checked, all set to the level, all set to the line. Now is the time to do the rebar check, to check if all castings items are in and to the correct position. And it is the time now, after under pressure, we need to push a little bit fixers, chippies, everyone to make it spot on for the concrete. So let's go! So guys, we will be checking the thermal break, if it's all as per drawing, as this actually we can start maybe checking even before the steel is laid. So that will be the first item to check, and let's have a look at the drawing here. This is the balcony here, we had a look on the last video with the TB thermal break here, and this, if we marked it straight on the decking, the guys can bring it even before the steel, and that's the better way. Even before that, we can start checking. So I'd really recommend you to do it, and have a look on that video here when I'm checking this. Actually, you see this only decking there, and the thermal break is ready before the fix is jumping on top. So wherever you have a time, just jump there, because remember, it takes time to check them correctly, and then later everything is on top and you don't have much time. It's, you're really under pressure, and if anyone make a mistake setting them on the decking, then maybe you miss it too, and that's gonna be the problem. If we are lucky enough, if we can check this before, it's very good for us. And now we're gonna have a look at the rebar, and remember guys, at this point we need all the drawings with us all the time: G drawing, section drawing, and the rebar drawing now. And same story as always guys, if you got a time, if for instance half of the slab gonna be making ready and you're gonna be working on other stuff, keep coming and keep looking. Maybe the bottom steel is ready, maybe some additional bar already laid down, so you can check them, you can tick them off, and that's gonna take the pressure later when you're gonna be actually just before the pour. I want to show you also how that Schock Isokorb connector looks here. It's a nice section here, I found the brochure. That's how it's gonna be looking in your slab. You see the steel here, obviously gonna be on top. This is a cantilevered, and I'm gonna leave the link for this as well so you can have a look. So actually here it explains quickly how it works, what that thermal break works, not letting the thermal bridges to appear. So let's have a look guys at the bottom steel first. I got a nice drawing here, that's the same slab, you see the balcony is here, so that was that balcony with a step in the soffit. So we got the sections here as well, we got that nice step here with a steel now. And we got the second balcony with a thermal break here. And as always guys, always check the latest revision, make sure you got the latest information. This is most important. Sometimes you spend so much time, you're gonna be checking, and then you might realize that you work to the old drawing, which is a disaster. So let's come back to this guys, we're gonna have a look at the balconies here. And in this case guys, as I said, this is a bottom steel and the top steel is on the other drawing, so that's great. But what I want to tell you, sometimes you're gonna have a drawing which is gonna be showing that bottom top on the same drawing, maybe even the share links. It might not be that readable, and especially guys, remember that designers do it for the A1 drawing, so that should be big drawing, but on sites we work mostly with the A3 drawings. So it makes our life and fixes life a little bit more difficult, and it's not easy to see. What I would recommend you for this guys, I would separate the top steel with the bottom steel, print them on separate drawings and make your life easier, and obviously issue that way for the fixers as well. So coming back to this guys, we got that downstand beam here, and now we're gonna have a look here. So that's how we're gonna be looking, beam B1, so it's 200 wide, 755 deep. And you got information about the bars. I'm not gonna be digging too much into the information. This you can have a look on my other drawings when I'm explaining more about the rebars and about the schedule as well. And obviously we want a schedule as well always guys. This drawing's coming now with the schedules for us, and we wanna make sure we got all information with us. Nothing really happened at the bottom here. Well, we can have a look, we got an upstands here as well. So I have to remember about these ones to install them before we pour. As you can see, there are actually anchored in the slab, so they're gonna be difficult later, or drilling later. It's not the best solution really, as they should be actually properly anchored in the slab, as you can see here on this detail. But what we're going to be looking guys, always bottom and top, we're going to be looking for the additional steel, and this typically going to be the bigger rebar, and we want to make sure they are inside. We go in here, we got H12 and we got 5H20, so that looks like that's going to be additional one. We want to make sure the big bars are in position, so we're going to jump here. We have 5 of these bars next to the balcony. This is going to be 20 mil bars. We want to make sure fixers not missing them and everything is installed, so it's 20 mil as well here. And let's quickly go up here, and I'm gonna jump to the top steel. So let's have a look at the top steel guys. I think this is gonna be more interesting, and we got the columns here, and that's gonna be a big moment on top. So we're definitely gonna have some additional bars on top of the columns, like here, this bar here, it's T2. So I think that asterisk here, that star, means that's the additional bar. These drawings are actually quite good, so probably it's gonna tell us here that the star means additional bar. So every time when you're gonna have a column guys, they're gonna be extra bars like this one here running this way, so that's gonna be our top two. They should be laid first before top one, and they're gonna be laid from here to here, so that's our top two. And the other direction, that's our top one here guys, and this is gonna be running from here to here, so you can see it clearly from here to here, and that should be in this case 13 20 mil bars position number 39 and 200 millimeter centers. So that's how it looks, guys. We want to make sure all around the balconies all these bars are in. As you could see on the bottom, there was some extra bars, so there will be probably some extra bars here on top as well. And guys, we want to make sure all the trimmer bars on the trimmer detail are done and around the boxes. So we got the trimmer detail here, we can have a look. We got 12 mil bars around the boxes, guys. Sometimes you're gonna find on the detail as well, like a trimmer detail, you're gonna find bars like this which have to be put. So that'll be like anti-crack bars here. So just to make sure you got all the trimmers now as you go. So guys, what else I can tell you about the slabs like this one? You're probably gonna have some shredlings, and this is very important. As you can see here, they not issue on the drawing. And let's go back quickly here. Here, where you're gonna find the information, find the second floor slab, core walls, bottom steel, and punching shear. So as I always say, guys, first of all, you go through all the information here, all the legend, all the info on the drawing, and only then you're gonna be able actually to compile all the information, all the drawings, and make sure actually you got all the info. But as I say, on the slabs like this, a residential, you're gonna always find some shellings. And I got the drawing here as well, we're gonna have a look together. It doesn't look, there is a many columns with the shellings, so you can see only that side here, on the left side, a PSC1, a PSC5, PSC4, so next to the balconies, no middle columns. They're quite heavy loaded actually, but they don't have a shellings. And as you can see on that side, there's no shellings as well. So maybe because of that thermal break here as well, you see that column takes all that load from here to here, and the slab sits only on two of these edges. So maybe that's the reason why when the designer was checking the forces and the loads here, we're gonna need shellings. So we're gonna come here, we're gonna double check that PSC3 here. So PSC3, that's the one here. And as you can see here, we got the shelling, so we got shelling here. And if you look at drawing like this, guys, you can see straight away that these designers, they know what's happening. They know what they're doing, guys. As this beam here, it's 755 deep beam. So if there's gonna be any punch here, if that slab gonna crack, it's gonna happen here. It's never gonna happen here on the beam. And I see on the many drawings, I see the steps in the slabs, guys, the big steps and the beams like this. And they still ask us to use the shellings here, which means that they really don't know what they're talking about. But anyway, I can see after this drawing that these guys are really good. And I'm really happy to see this. So we want to definitely make sure these are in. This is the very important, if not the most important thing, guys, in terms of this slab with no beams, with no column heads. The punching shear destruction is really bad, guys. You cannot do anything about it. So as you can see here, that's how the shelling should be looking if you look at a section here. So the steel is checked. And as I said, if you go back here, we want to make sure all these boxes are in the position now, guys. And all these boxes are reinforced. All that trimmer detail I showed you is used now. And everything is as per design. And the next thing, guys, what we're going to be checking, we want to have a look now at that slab edge here. As Chip is going to be closing the slab edge now. And we want to make sure all the halfens are in and all this balcony stuff are in the position now, and we're gonna make sure it's good to go. So let's have a look here on that balcony stabs. I got the drawing here showing the balcony. So that's how your balcony stab gonna be looking here. I think there's a company called Sapphire. I was using this as well before. So always, guys, in this case, and to be honest, always in your life, you want to ask yourself what can go wrong. And in this case, we can have a position of the stabs wrong. So what we're gonna do about it, we want to use a template, and they often provide the template. And if not, make sure one gonna be made on site and you're gonna be using the template, guys. I really recommend you that. The next thing wrong might happen, they might be set to the wrong level. So we want to make sure all these three stabs are set to the one level, and even if they're not to the perfect level, we want to actually make sure they are set to the same level, guys. So all these stabs here, here, and here are set to the same level. And if all of them hide 5 mil, maybe even 10 mil, guys, but all at the same level, you're gonna still get away with it. But if this one, for instance, is 10 mil high, this one is 5 mil low, this one is 10 mil low, that means there's gonna be 20 mil difference between this one and this one, and that's gonna be a problem. But we're gonna talk about this a little bit when we're gonna be doing the as builds, as there are still some chances it's not gonna be end of the world. And the last things about the stabs, guys, obviously we wanna make sure they are actually in the level. So we're gonna use the small spirit level. If we don't have one, we're gonna grab one from the cheapie, and we wanna make sure actually the stabs themselves are actually set in the level with no slope of them or nothing like that, as this is gonna be the problem too. So guys, coming back to that slab edge here, remember that dashed line we checked on the last video, there was a half end here. So we wanna make sure now they are set to the correct level and the right half end is used. There might be few on sides, different ones, some might come to the columns, some might be on the soffit of the slab, and some might be on the edge. So you need to make sure the proper one is used as well. I think we're going really good now. We're checking everything, and we want to make sure, guys, now all the starter bars for the columns are ready. There might be new columns coming for the next level slabs. We want to make sure new starters are installed in, and if not, we want to make sure actually these starters on existing columns got enough splice. This is very important, as I've seen sometimes people pouring and you got a small bars. You don't really need that tape, you know, from far away it's wrong, and just you run in and tell them you need to splice them. So that happens as well. We want to make sure before we pour we got a proper splice. This is very important as well. So guys, now when we are all happy with all these castings, with all the balconies, with all the extra steel, we want to make sure we got the proper cover. So we're going to be checking the cover here, obviously on the slab edges. It's really simple now, but we want to make sure we got a cover here. And typically, guys, they're using same chairs for all the slab. So in areas like this, we're going to be more steel, more additional steel on top, it might be less cover. So we want to make sure we're going to grab the fixtures and make them to open the chairs a little bit in these areas when that red bar are here. We want to make sure we got the top cover right, so we're gonna have this probably around each column, guys. So we want to make sure we got a cover, as I said, boxes as well here, all that trimmer details. So you can see actually on that drawing, it shows here on the main drawing, you got the diagonal bars, so the diagonal bars are issued here, so you're gonna typically see them in all the boxes. And we want to cover here around the box as well. Obviously in this case this bar cannot just go through the box here, but you can put somewhere here and somewhere here, maybe additional ones anyway. So guys, if you're all happy now, you check the bottom steel, top steel, additional ones, shellings, castings, thermal brakes, everything, stops, balconies, Jesus, this is crazy. And you're going, just please stop, guys. Stop and turn around. Take your GA drawing and have a one more final look again, please. Open that drawing, guys. Just count the boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make sure you got enough of the fire corals. Make sure you got big boxes. Have a last look about this hall fence, guys. Have a look at the balconies. If you got a proper number of balcony stubs. Have a look if all that starters actually look all right. And if that still looks right, guys, you're gonna see it from far that everything is right. And I really want you to get that habit. I know you're under pressure, don't have much time, but this is only 5 minutes, guys. Just open the drawing, have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Balcony there, balcony there, balcony there. Okay, you can go. That really makes your life easier and you can just sleep well later, trust me. So guys, I think that will be all in today's video. We've done all inspection, we check all the steel and everything as I said. So we're happy to go, we can order the concrete now and we can pour that slab. And obviously guys, on the next video, we're gonna jump on the fresh concrete and we're gonna start marking and we're gonna check the column height and obviously we're gonna do the as-built. And after the as-built, actually, you wanna see if you got everything spot on. So guys, thank you again for watching and as always, leave the thumbs up if you like it and don't forget to subscribe to the channel as there are going to be more videos coming. And after we're going to finish the slab, we're going to go back to the ground, we're going to be doing the groundworks, drainage and all the works below the ground level. So see you next time.